the emergency law. The emergency law has been in Egypt for 30 years now. This is Khaled Said. Khaled Said is 20 years old. He's from Alexandria. When he tried to expose the government on the internet, he was beaten to death in the entrance of a building. They closed the entrance of the building in the street and they beat him to death. It's happened. This is why raised the uprising. This is why we are here. This is the emergency law that has been in Egypt for 30 years for whoever tries to talk or express his rights. No for emergency law.
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 No for Hosni Mubarak.
No for Hosni Mubarak.
No for Hosni Mubarak.
No for Hosni Mubarak. No for Hosni Mubarak.
Changing the cabinet is not enough. Down with the whole government.
Down with the whole government.
Down with Hosni Mubarak.
Our
demands are simple. We do not want Hosni Mubarak. We want to elect our own president. We want to change the whole government. Only three demands we're asking for. We're asking for freedom for Egypt. We're asking for freedom to Egypt. No for Hosni Mubarak.
And raised in the U.S. And to be quite honest, I didn't know a lot about what was going on in Egypt until very recently. And I want to thank the power of the people for informing me about the struggle that's happening there. And I want to thank particularly the youth who informed me through Facebook, actually, was my first point of contact. And, you know, when I read what was going on there, I had to be... It really touched a place inside of me because Puerto Rico, as some of you may or may not know, is a colony of the United States. And we have been under the dictatorship of the United States since 1893, and also since before that by Spain, 1493. So we are a colonized people. My family came here basically in exile. And so every time that I hear a story about people rising up and fighting against injustice and fighting against these kinds of dictatorships and this lack of democracy, it speaks to my own history and to my own people. When I hear about the stories in Tibet and the stories in Palestine and the stories in Egypt, it really speaks to my own history. And I think that it's so important that we're all here together, some of us coming simply in solidarity, like myself, to stand with all of you who are representing your nation. So I just want to say thank you for all of us for coming here today and standing in the cold to honor the power of the people.
Was Obama's reaction. Now, Obama is a man of change, and he lives by that title, by changing his attitude towards the Arabs from when he addressed them in Cairo in 2009. Back then, he called for change. He wanted democracy. He wanted change in the Middle East. And now that there's change in the Middle East, now that the people want the change in the Middle East, now we're not sure if we want to give democracy to the Egyptians. Maybe they're better if they have a dictatorship. Maybe somehow Arabs aren't worthy of democracy. Are we different?
No.
But I think the government thinks we're a little different. We can't build mosques where we'd like to build mosques, regardless of how far they are from anywhere. And now, we're not necessarily worthy about more democracy. Now, we want democracy. Huh? We're going to take it. But we're not going to get any funding now that it might actually go to the people. We're not going to have any pull. And now, not any of our neighbors are going to really be too eager to be our partners with us. If anything, I'm going to assume that the news is going to cover a lot of shady things going on in Egypt now. A lot of shady characters. And how somehow the Muslim Brotherhood is this fascist group that is going to overtake everything. So yeah. Wish us luck, and hopefully one day we'll be worthy of democracy. But before that, let's just say, Hosni, Hosni, can't you see?
Hosni, Hosni, can't you see?
Egyptians want democracy!
Egyptians want democracy!
Hosni, Hosni, can't you see?
Hosni, Hosni, can't you see?
Egyptians want democracy!
Egyptians want democracy!
Thank you, Pete.
Thank you. Democracy, a real democracy.
rather than just election that is already paid for and nobody knows what's going on with it. Okay. So thank you so much for the Egyptian standing here, and I'm really proud of the great Egyptian in Cairo trying to change the system there and to have a true democracy. Thank you so much.